Assalamu alaikum viewers, please like, share and subscribe this channel. Links of PDF files used in this video are given in description. So today is a part 3 of a lecture series about bonding situation in metal carbonyls, and in this particular lecture we will focus on spectroscopic evidence of back bonding. So in order to have information whether there exists a back bonding in a particular metal carbonyl or not, we will use the IR spectroscopy or infrared spectroscopy. This is also called as organic spectroscopy, or it is also called as vibrational spectroscopy. If we see here in the electromagnetic spectrum, here lies infrared region, which is inferior to visible region of the electromagnetic radiation, whereas it comes before the microwave region. And this infrared region is further divided into these three regions, which is near infrared region, mid infrared region and far infrared region. So usually when we draw a spectrum of IR, we take value of wave number on x-axis, whereas we take intensity of the peak in the form of transmittance on y-axis. So if we see here that the values are ranging from 4000 per centimeter to 400 per centimeter, and these values are important, and all of the molecular vibrations lie in this spectrum. So actually this is absorption spectroscopy, and infrared spectroscopy is dealing with actually the vibrational transitions of molecules. So if we see here, this is a particular IR spectrum, and it is mentioning various ranges of different functional groups, especially organic functional groups that are present, and we can have information about these functional groups if these are present in some particular molecule. So here you can see a particular IR spectrum. As we see here that this is the y-axis, which is shown in the form of transmittance, whereas the x-axis, it is in the form of wave number. The spectrum starts from 4000 per centimeter and it lies about 500 to 400 centimeter. This region of spectrum, like 1000 to 500 per centimeter, it is called as fingerprint region, whereas the region from 4000 centimeter to 1000 centimeter, this region is called as functional group region. So as we have seen here that there are different functional groups that show the ranges of peaks. For example, here we have seen the OH stretching frequency, and which ranges from 3400 per centimeter to 3200 per centimeter. Similarly, if the molecule contains CH bond, so its stretching frequency will lie from 3100 per centimeter to 2850 per centimeter. Similarly, the ranges of C triple bond, C and C triple bond, and lies from 2260 per centimeter to 2100 per centimeter. And here comes the CO or carbonyl or carbon monoxide, which we are interested, and its values mainly lie from 1800 per centimeter to 1650 per centimeter. Similarly, the NH stretch also lies from 3500 per centimeter to 3300 per centimeter, and similarly the alkyne CH stretch has its peak around 3300 per centimeter. So in this way, each functional group has its range, and from this area of the peak we can identify that whether a molecule contains that functional group or not. So mainly in this particular lecture we are mainly concerned with this carbonyl stretch, and it mainly lies from 1800 per centimeter to 1650 per centimeter. Another important thing to remember is that these ranges are just ideas, and the actual peaks may vary from these points. So this is not a specific pinpoint range. This range may vary from one point to another depending upon the sample condition and conditions under which the sample has been taken. One other important thing is that this is a type of absorption spectroscopy, and we have taken here transmittance. The reason is that we are dealing with vibrational transitions, and these transitions are so much less that when we draw a graph between absorbance and wave number, then the peaks will be too much small. So in order to make the peaks visible, we have drawn the graph between between transmittance and wave number rather than absorbance. So as we know that absorbance is equal to negative log of t, so this is also called as a is equal to 1 over t of law. So transmittance and absorbance are inversely proportional to each other, and there is the factor of log. It means that the value of any absorption, if we transmit it into a transmittance, then its signal will be 10 times higher as compared to that of absorbance. So due to this, now we can see that the negative relation between the absorbance and transmittance, the peaks are going in downward direction, and the intensity of the peaks has been raised 10 times more as compared to the absorption. So in this way, we take help from a particular IR spectrum. Now in the above spectrum, I have mentioned the term of stretching frequency. So actually the molecule vibrations that are occurring that are observed in IR spectrum, that they are of two types. These are actually stretching vibrations and bending vibrations. So though two major types, stretching vibrations, and these are the bending vibrations. Stretchings are of two types, symmetrical and asymmetrical, whereas bending vibrations include scissoring, twisting, rocking and whacking. Here in this picture we can see how the symmetrical stretching occurs and how anti-symmetrical stretching occurs. Actually we need more energy to stretch the molecular bonds, so as a result of which the stretching frequencies are absorbed and the spectrum lies in the major functional group region, whereas the scissoring, twisting, rocking and whacking are bending vibrations, and the energy of these transitions in IR spectrum is represented from 1000 to 400 per centimeter. So the bending vibrations are not so much important as compared to the stretching vibrations, and in order to have information about functional groups, we are mainly focusing on stretching vibrations, or we can say that we are mainly focused on the functional group region of the IR spectrum. Yes, bending vibrations are important. These are used to confirm the major functional group region, and these are fingerprint region, and these are specific to each molecule. For example, we have some benzene derivative, so bending vibrations will tell us that yes, there is benzene, either it is orthobenzene, metabenzene or parabenzene. So in this way the each type of a functional group is further confirmed by bending vibrations. But these are so much minute and these are so much confusing. So our mainly focus of the carbonyl backbonding situation is, so we are mainly focused on the stretching vibrations which are symmetrical and anti-symmetrical. This diagram shows that how we can see here, prominent is the peak of carbonyl in IR spectrum. So due to this so much intensity of this peak, we are particularly using the IR spectroscopy in order to have information about whether backbonding lies in a particular metal carbonyl or not. So this is the very sharp peak and it is one of the most prominent peak of the IR spectrum. Now again our focus will be on how a structure A is formed and how a structure B is formed. Here we can see here that this is the lone pair of the carbonyl which is sharing with the empty hybrid orbital of metal. So in this way a sigma bond is formed between metal and carbon, and if we represent this diagram in this simplest diagram, so it is here like this. that between metal and carbon there is a single bond, whereas between carbon and oxygen there is a triple bond. Now what happens if there is back bonding? So in that case, the filled metal d orbital will overlap with empty pi star orbital of carbonyl, and in this way, along with this sigma, another bond is formed which is joining above and below the line, which is called as pi bond. And if we represent this diagram in this simplest form, so here we can see that in this diagram there is a double bond between metal and carbon, and as the carbon valency is 4, so there lies a double bond between carbon and oxygen, and this extra bond has been shifted on this oxygen in the form of an other lone pair. Now our case is that, let's see, we have a complex which is iron pentacarbonyl. Now we want to see either this complex contains B form or A form, either the complex contains back bonding or not. So we can have this information from the peaks position of carbonyl. Actually, the metal carbon bond peaks are not coming so good in IR spectroscopy. So we have developed another way that in place of metal carbon information, we can have indirect information about back bonding by having spectrum of carbonyl C triple bond O or C double bond O. Like if there is a C triple bond O, then we must have this conclusion that structure A is present, and if C double bond O is present, that it means structure B is present. So from the carbonyl stretching frequency, we can have information that whether the system contains back bonding or not. So here are some stretching frequencies which we must remember. So if we see here, the stretching frequency of carbonyl in free form, like free form carbon monoxide in air, it contains this value of IR spectrum, which is 2155 per centimeter. However, when carbonyl is attached with metal, then its stretching frequency decreases and its range is from 2125 per centimeter to 1850 per centimeter. Remember that these ranges are flexible. Now, if only A structure is dominant, like if there is no back bonding and only this A structure is dominant, then IR will be at 2125 per centimeter. And similarly, if there is back bonding and 100% back bonding and 100% B is the contributing structure, so the IR value will decrease and it will come into 1850 per centimeter. The reason is that now this bond is C double bond O, not C triple bond O. So as the bond has been shifted from C triple bond O to C double bond O, so the IR value will also decrease, because we need less energy to stretch C double bond O as compared to C triple bond O. So the IR value of the peak will come at 1850 per centimeter. Now next case is, if both A and B, like structure A and B, are equally contributing, or 50% contributing structure A and 50% is contributed by structure B, so in that case the stretching frequency of carbonyl will be at 2000 per centimeter. So it means the mid region is 2000 per centimeter, and any value of carbonyl IR which is greater than 2000 per centimeter, it means structure A is dominant. So this point has been summarized here, so that if A is more dominant than B, then carbonyl stretching frequency will be greater than 2000 per centimeter. However, if B is contributing more, so the IR value will be less than 2000 per centimeter. So if B is greater than A, then carbonyl stretching frequency will be less than 2000 per centimeter. However, if molecule is neutral and then so much less area of a peak of carbonyl is coming, like around 1850 centimeter, then it means there lies a bridging carbonyl. So in this way we can identify that whether a bridging carbonyl is present or not. Actually, in bridging carbonyl, this is the situation. Just like a ketonic group, a carbonyl behave like a ketonic group, and a typical ketonic group has IR value around 1850 per centimeter. Now there are two 1850 per centimeter values. One, because of only when there is completely B structure is dominant, and one when there is a bridging carbonyl. Now, how we can differentiate these two IR values? The reason is that if the structure B is charged, like if the metal has a negative charge and then 1850 per centimeter value is coming, that it then it is not due to the bridging carbonyl, it is due to the extreme level of backbonding. However, if molecule is neutral and then the value is around 1850 per centimeter, then it means that this value is not decreased due to the big backbonding, but this value has been decreased due to this ketonic formation. And in this ketonic formation there also lies C double bond O. So in this way we will be confirmed that there lies a bridging carbonyl in the molecule. So in this way we take the help of IR spectroscopy in order to have information about back bonding. I hope you have understood this lecture. If you have any question, let me know in the comments. I will respond as soon as possible. Okay, thank you. Allah Hafiz.